a chance to talk from Japan by Zoom. COVID-19 for travel is still hard for me, especially re-enter to Japan. Everyone is have to 40 days isolation. It is much better than original 14 days, much better than 40 days at medieval area, but I cannot travel to France now. But thank you for giving, I can put from Zoom. Next one is, fortunately I have good bakery at my place, so I have prepared today for croissant and coffee for next break. So today I'll talk about shape optimization for heat exchanger, and I'll present some techniques for VFN. This is part of joint work with Ogawa-san at Tensor Corporation, but today's contents, all contents are purely academic. But I hope I can soon apply my method to real industry application. So I stop my video. So this is a video. Okay, to explain the governing equation and what is my objective of the optimization. So first, I would like to introduce boundaries. From the left side, there is inlet. I put the positive flow here. And then I try to control the pressure value at the outlet. So the boundary condition is a little bit different from the usual system. And I'd like to optimize the shape of the internal cylinder inside of the Navier Stokes flow. Now here, for the simplicity, I completely ignore the effect of the gravity. So the system is just the result external force and plus the heat convection equation without buoyancy. So this system is rather simple. And there is parameter for Reynolds number and also the pressure to the outlet. And there's the diffuse coefficient in the heat convection equation. The cost function is integration of the thermal gradient on the whole internal surface. So here, gamma tilde one is a combination of upper and lower surface plus the surface of the cylinder, which shape should be optimized. So first, I'd like to introduce how to treat the boundary conditions for dynamic pressure on Navier Stokes equation, and also how to treat this kind of the surface integration by domain integration, which is much easier for computation. So the weak formulation for Navier Stokes with dynamic pressure can be written by curl-curl form. This is a little bit, not standard way, I think, but I refer the old paper by Professor Pirono at 1994. I employ this way. So let's start from the weak formulation. And by assuming the divergence freeness, this weak formulation is equivalent to the strong formulation with divergence of gradient minus Laplacian plus gradient P. This is given, we can calculate by integration by parts. And the importance is nonlinear term is expressed by the convection of the flow is expressed by rotation times U plus this value. So we can see the strong formulation in the domain is satisfied. And for the boundary, the rest of the integration by parts on the boundary, we can see dynamic pressure appears on the gamma two. We set the function space for velocity, and the velocity is vanished on the inlet and also above and top. And also the outlet, the tangential component of the velocity will vanish. This is setting of the function space, and we need to solve this kind of weak formulation. But to solve by finite element method, there is some, we have to pay attention for something on this kind of the program. So I'd like to use a P1 approximation for both velocity and pressure. So here there is a two difficulties for this formulation. One is curl-curl form is only coercive on divergence freeness. So during factorization, there is some problem happen. And also, this is well known that the P1, P1 approximation does not satisfy its function. So we have to do some stabilization. So here I have two stabilizations. One is for this kind of the causality. I added the divergence U times divergence V. And also this is another one is very standard stabilizing finite element scheme for the pressure stabilization. So finally, for the matrix form, I will obtain this kind of the so-called KKT system. A0 is comes from the curl formulation. A1 is a kind of linearized nonlinear term. This is unsymmetric matrix that appears on the Newton equation. So B is a divergence operator, and then B transpose is the gradient operator, and B is divergence operator. And D is a stabilization for the pressure. So we can see A0 is symmetric, and C is also symmetric. And fortunately, the kernel of C and B is the same. And also the image of A0 is the same as the divergence free velocity field. So finally, we can see the stiffness matrix of Stokes equation, which means without A1 is contains the causality. So thanks to the causality, we can use domain decomposition and stiffness matrix in subdomain can be factorized because of thanks to the causality. And also, I'll show very, very briefly show fact that the diagonal component part of the A0 plus C of velocity is invertible. So this is easily shown, but I use this some also on decomposition of divergence gradients on kernel of A0. So I use these two properties, and I can show A0 plus C is invertible, which is same as adding by B transpose B added to the A0. This is the same thing. So finally, even for the some non-standard form of the curl, discretization is something simple. Next one is how to write of the cost function of the surface integration of the gradient of the heat gradient should be integrated by on the surface. So weak formulation for the thermal convection is like that. This is very simple, just the convection of the heat and plus of the diffusion with diffusion coefficient kappa. So this satisfies also strong formulation plus the boundary conditions. On the boundary and the on the outlet, I only put the minimum boundary condition. Number two, tilde is out. So the surface integration is between can be expressed by domain integration using eta asterisk. This function is a kind of the harmonic extension of which takes on the value one on the surface, the target surface. So instead of the compute of the just surface, I can compute this value by through standard domain integration. So next one is the main topic of this shape of optimization. I'd like to minimize this cost function with a constraint with the dynamics of the fluid plus the thermal diffusion equation. So thermal fluid is written by weak formulation. And here, this function BQ xi becomes a Lagrange multiplier against this cost function. So the objective is to find the extremal of this Lagrangian. So the idea is very simple, just to take the computer state problem and compute adjoint problem. And after that, we can find the extremal of the cost function against the shape variation. So first, the state problem is very easy to just same as standard Navier Stokes equation. And adjoint problem is also the very simple way I'll show the very briefly. Here is the state program for the Navier Stokes plus the heat equation. So if we take the variation against the Lagrange multiplier d cube xi, so this delta d delta p and delta xi is a variation. So we can get this very this, just the same standard Navier Stokes equation plus the heat equation. An adjoint problem is obtained by using such solution of the state problem, UP theta. We can get the V2 xi by taking another variation. But here, the adjoint problem itself becomes a linear equation. The state problem is because that is due to Navier Stokes, this is non linear. But adjoint problem is just linear equation. It's just taking of the variation of the non linear term. So here also that's content of the force from force function. So this is just very standard way. Yes, and then finally, I would like to solve this optimization problem by deforming of the shape. Now I'd like to change of the shape of the domain by function phi. And my objective on this slide is to show understand what is the shape derivative. The first one is material derivative, and also we need to think about there are a lot of the differential divergence or rotation and other differential operators of the first order. We have to prepare the shape derivative with the gradient. Here, the shape of gradient is very easy. Just consider about the deformation of the F. And just this is comes from the expressed side this way. So F minus transpose V is you can easily compute from this side. So the derivative of the functional is obtained by like that. So finally, we can have this way divergence T is the additional term is appear. And the real computation we can suppose the shape derivative is vanished on the whole domain. But that means the velocity or temperature is completely moves the same for as the domain movement. The derivative of the domain integration is same way. But here, if the gradient operator will be changed, the metric will be changed by domain deformation. So here is just a simple example of a scalar function. But we need to prepare for the vector valued differential operator of first kind. That's the divergence or rotation. And also, but this is nothing difficult, not difficult to obtain the, all the stuff. So finally, we have to obtain some automatic change of the differential operator by adding of the change of metric and also the change of the volume. So the most important issue for today's Navier Stokes, we had the curl-curl formation. So this can be written by kind of the combination of the through the tensor of the grad U. U is vector. So the grad U transpose is 3x3 tensor. Applying the previous consideration, we can get finally the shape derivative of this variational equation comes like the below. So the last thing is how to implement this kind of the integration by free FM, which is the next step. So finally, we found we can obtain the shape derivative or Lagrangians of the Navier distributions. There's a lot of terms, but anyway, if I load the all steps by free script, I can get the sensitivity against the variation of the domain. So now I will use just a very simple algorithm to find x value by gradient crossover, which is the direction is determined by kind of the H norm, which is actually realized by elastic equations with that is described the deformation of the domain. So, but the important issue is the setting of the boundary conditions, because now we want to change the cylinder surface but we need to pay attention on the kind of the boundary condition. On the inlet and outlet, these are to be fixed. And also the little bit difficulty on the top and bottom surface, because the shape of the cylinder will be changed like that. This the surface of the cylinder will change. And that means we cannot change of the total shape of the upper and lower surface. So that means I put the slip conditions on the top and the bottom surface for the domain variation. And also I don't put any boundary condition on the cylinder. But the next figure, we can see if the shape will change. Some part, all the surface of the cylinder may exceed of the top and the bottom surface. This is a bad thing. I'd like to want to change of the shape of the surface. So I put some kind of the constraint, which means the deformation is not exceed on the bottom and top and the bottom surface, which means x minus delta tau psi is deformation. Because of I use the gradient solver, delta tau is two times step. So the one step, little bit small deformations. And then every time that should be inside the top and the bottom. This is kind of the variation in inequality problem. So to solve this one, I'm using the IPOPT, that is very easy to use from the PFM. But this is cannot be parallelized, but which use paradiso, that is slightly parallelized, but on the only works of the shared memory machine. It cannot be run on distributed today. So fortunately, Navier Stokes can be parallelized in distributed way by using HPDDM, thanks to PL. But IPOPT is never fit to the distributed computation. The next idea, second idea is to implement the primary dual active set method by hand, which can be parallelized, but I'm working on this second one. So finally, the important issue is how to move the mesh on the during computation. So this figure is not so easy to see, but you can see the surface is moving. And sometimes the original surface is become another kind of a surface. So thank you, Frederick. Here is the edge is little bit spread it. So I have to change of the boundary of the, this is little bit surface becomes the no more moving surface. So I have to change of the levels of the interfaces. And below is for the remeshing, I have to move the surface interface, but internally I would like to refine the whole meshes, especially surrounding of the edges. So the left here is a coarsened mesh by MMD3D. And after I call the JMSH for the tetrahedral decomposition with a refinement around the edges. So I use this combination. Finally, but I have to change up the surface level. So I asked how to work with this way, the PL on this summer. He answered me this. We can use a change for the function by setting of the local levels for the local element. This point is I faces is defined by locally. So we have for step one tetrahedron, we have four faces, and we can prepare all the information for this, each surfaces. And then finally, if we call the change, it works fine. And then for this figure, we can change the labels. So the final one is the technique to write, how to write the gradient operator on the, for the PFM. So there are several terms. And unfortunately, using macro of the tensor and vector, that is not difficult to write. So importance is rotation, the curl operator receives the three vectors and the return three vector. And also the tensor could be written by matrix form. And here the sensitivity can be calculated like this way. So this is rather simple way, and then thanks for this writing, is debug is not so difficult. So I can write properly and the integration. But the important issue is for the, there are a lot of terms. So I need to choose the carefully the numerical quadrature, which I use the lowest order quadrature here. So finally, I will show the very preliminary result for the shape is deformed for the low Reynolds number like that. So here is the flow from the inlet as the force flow, and then the flow is the flow. So the shape is changed, and to maximize of the heat gradient, this shape will change like that. And if the Reynolds number becomes much higher, like 50, domain will be changed. Right? So this is my presentation. So the difference like two. One is one. First one is for to understand of the dynamic, how to treat the dynamic pressure in the mixed formulation. Next one is this is another new book from the Professor Zegami, who is expert on the shape of formulation in Japan. So now I'm working on the second derivative of the shape derivative, which can be useful for the backward order method for the gradient flow or the station solution or the, to find the optimal shape. Thank you for your attention.
We have time for one question. Ali, as you go. So in the end,
why do you use P1 P1 approximation? It's not. Is it allowed?
So that just one thing is this is economical for compute of the shape gradient. Because all the gradient becomes just constant in each element. Of course, we can use the P2, P1, but that case is a shape become much more contain higher order and the numerical scheme, numerical pressure should be higher just for the computational complexity.
Okay, so thanks again, Atsushi.